So the Republican Party, all of the candidates and even some just members of Congress, leaders of the party all over the place, they've been in the media kind of coming up with their ideas on how we need to respond to the terrorist attacks in Paris, specifically the handling of refugees from Syria. Jeb Bush believes that we should only focus our attention on saving the Christians in Syria, only bringing Christians from Syria into America after they've been carefully screened. Now, here's the problem that Jeb Bush has, and I think a lot of the Republican Party has. It's not, you know, let's only focus on saving Christians. Stop looking at it as a religious divide. These are human beings. Not all Christians are great. Not all Muslims are evil. But when you start to break it down in those black and white terms, you're creating a problem. You know, the Republican Party is absolutely right. There is a war on religion happening today. Unfortunately, it's the Republican Party that is waging it. There is a real humanitarian crisis in the world right now. There is a very real problem of terrorism in the world right now. But Jeb Bush, by saying we should only help the Christians, is not offering any real solutions that are going to help anyone. And take it a little bit further. Jeb Bush is out there talking about the need to help these Christians. But let's not forget that his brother, George W. Bush, created the conditions in the Middle East that gave rise to ISIS. And I think that's what Jeb Bush needs to be answering for right now. And I think a lot of people are already having that discussion. Jeb Bush is not one of them. But this could easily come up in a future Republican debate, in any kind of Q&A session that Jeb Bush chooses to do, because there's no denying that fact. We know that what the United States did in Iraq after 9/11 is what led to the creation of ISIS and the instability in Iraq. So, Jeb, you can talk all you want about only wanting to save Christians. It's not going to change the fact that your family, the Bush family, has blood on their hands.